melanin comes with compassion. Melanin comes with soul that we call it soul. We soul brothers and sisters. That's the melanin that connects us. Right. So the people that don't have it are a little less. They may not have the compassion or the when they were sent to the mountains of Caucasus, when they didn't have the power of the sun, that the sun then started to deteriorate them. So then they're acting out of fear. They're acting out of low self-esteem. They're acting out of a deficiency. Mm-hmm. So therefore, the only way that they can act is evil. The only way they have to rob, steal, rape, kill, and
fight or flight
in order to survive.
Exactly.
So then these people who didn't have what we had, and when I say we, I speak of the melanated people.
Right.
They had to be savages. They had to be barbaric. They had, because they're in these Nordic mountains, they're in these rough torrential environments. Mm. So they're acting as animals.
Right.
So they're the ones that are actually closer to animals. They're the ones that are actually the true savages. And then they built up such this, I don't want to say warrior, but
the beginning of my education, literal re-education. I am committed to deeper connections, more profound learning, and strengthening the bond between our two cultures today, every day, going forward. So the bond, whenever the BLM or the blacks take the focus off the white man, meaning the European people, Western, Northwestern European people, and start talking about Jewish supremacy, they always snap that whip and get them back in line. And this is quite frankly painful to watch. Painful to see, Nick Cannon. You are going to be known as a sellout for the rest of your life. Philosopher Dr. Stack, Devin Stack of Blackpilled, says Jewish power is just a myth, retweeting this this pathetic apology, insincere apology. So now this is what Nick Cannon said about white people, but he only gets fired. This is applauded and trendy and encouraged in the white supremacist media, this type of sentiment that they perpetuate all the time as well. But notice he's not apologizing to white people.
Agree,
right?
That when you're confronted with evil in the world, it destroys the Tzelem Elohim. The Talmud teaches, Kashem she partzofehem shonim. The Talmud teaches.
The Talmud provides generous loopholes for adultery. It says the penalty for adultery does not include sex with a minor, the wife of a minor, or the wife of a heathen. There is a special antagonism between the Talmud and Jesus. The Talmud attacks him everywhere it can, even his mother. It naturally followed that the scribes declared Christ to be a bastard. In its article on Jesus, the Jewish Encyclopedia says that Jewish writings defame Christ. They subjected him to four deaths: stoning, burning, decapitation, and strangling. The Talmud also says he is now in hell, punished with boiling hot excrement.